Hi everyone. So in the previous video, we created a basic application with React hooks. Now we will see the demo and we will see how the components are working. Okay. So here, this is the add user form and this is the table. We see, I will be adding few information here, add new user. This is added here, right? Now I will do edit. Edit it is working fine. I can able to edit the form. So this is working perfectly fine. Okay, now I will try to understand the code a little bit here. What if in the edit user form we are not using this hook, and then you will understand the importance of this particular hook here. Okay, I am adding new thing. Now if I just edit this and I click on edit, it's not being populated, right? Why? Because the component is rendered. I clicked on edit, so the current user is updated. But when you click on edit again, the current user is updated and we are passing the new props, but that component is not receiving it. That's why we need that use effect hook here. Whenever the props is getting changed for this component, we have to reflect it. We have to set it. We have to set the current user so that this props can be used. So this props can be set for the current user object. And this user and name and username can be populated. Okay, other thing is we can inspect and see the component structure and the hooks we are having. So if we have a React add-on tools, this will be helpful. Here we can see these are the two components, edit user form and the user table. User table is just receiving these users in the props. Okay, and there are two methods. They are calling edit and delete, right? Delete, we are passing the ID. Edit, we are just passing the user object, and these are the initial users, the user data which we are receiving from the props for rendering. Okay, now if you go to edit user form, it is having the current user, the users. If in the state you can see, this is the current user object, the users which we are seeing on the screen. Now this is the current user because that is in the edit mode. If we just cancel the editing, then the state will become like this. It will have a two array objects. So here we can see both the users in an array, and our props are empty. But when you click on edit, and when you go here, then you can see editing is now true. These are the methods we have: update user, current user. These are the methods are defined in the props. Okay, and this is the current state. So from here you can just see the current component structure, and you can also debug it. This is the parent component which just have the state, which is having this user list information, and it is just receiving these events from the child components and updating the user object. Okay, thanks everyone. In the next video, what we can do is we can start writing the shopping cart application, and there also we will be using the React hooks like set state, use effect, maybe use reducer. If we have some mechanism to store more data, then we can use context, use reducer together to manage the local state for our components. Okay, thanks everyone. Thanks for watching.